Hello guys, this is Eddie from Real Gamers TV, and finally I'm releasing my Free For All Run and Gun tactics video for sniper running and gunning on Free For Alls. This series will help you to win or at least place top 3 in Free For All games with your sniper running and gunning without having to camp in a spot in the corner at the back of the map, which Payarch wants you to do. First I'll be starting off with the basics, but as the series progresses I'll be doing individual map run overs just to give everybody an insight into running and gunning for specific maps. Okay, starting off with the basics, the classes you would use to run and gun with your sniper on Free For Alls. Okay, for the first perk slot I would actually recommend Lightweight or Ghost. Both have their pros and cons. As for the second perk slot, I would actually recommend Steady Aim, Hardened or Sleight of Hands. It could actually be anything in the second perk slot, but Steady Aim is recommended for no scopes, as sometimes stabbing at close range is actually kind of hard. And for the final perk slot, I would actually recommend Hacker or Ninja only. And as for equipment, you could use a Tomahawk, a Semtex, but always equip a decoy and a claymore. I will explain that later in the later series. And as for weapons, you can use the L96 or the PSG, but if you're using the PSG, don't attach any attachments to it or you will get hit markers a lot. But I would actually recommend an L96 with extended mags, as it has enough ammo for you to run and gun and build up streaks. Killstreaks. Okay, with killstreaks, you always have to choose killstreaks that you know that you can get. So I would actually recommend a spy plane, a care package or a mortar team if you're a newbie to running and gunning on Free For All with a sniper. But if you're not, I'd actually recommend you put a napalm strike on, and instead of the mortar team, put on an attack helicopter, and it will help you get more kills. And always put a spy plane on. You can actually mix and match it, but spy plane is essential for it. So if you think you can handle it, you can even put 389 for example. In my opinion, there are actually three types of sniping styles you can play as. There's one, which is the opportunist sniper, as you're seeing now, which basically camps in corners, hides at the back of the map, and just picks up on little bits and pieces you can get. And this is basically how Treyarch want you to play as a sniper, but as you will find out, you just can't win a free-for-all game playing as this type of sniper, as you just won't be able to keep up even if you do maintain a good KD, so it's not essential you play like that all the time. And there's also, I'll call it the sly sniper, who likes to run and gun but stays out of basically close contact. He just runs and tries to kill people without them seeing him, which is actually quite good, and I recommend it for building streaks. And I'll like teach all of this stuff in my later episodes when I'm actually doing individual map setups, because for this type of sniper you'd actually need to have a little bit of knowledge on spawn locations and everything. It's not cheating. It's just slight knowledge, not exact knowledge, so you can build up streaks without meeting people at close combat. But as you know, there's always times that will happen. And finally, there's also one other style of sniping which I like to play as most often, which is just the mad sniper. Just go all out, and if you're playing on a small map such as Newtown, that is how you need to play basically. It's just all out, you don't really care about death, you just want to win. And if you want to win, you just play mad, you don't even know what you're doing sometimes. So just quit scoping, no scoping, hard scoping sometimes. Do whatever you think is right. And for this as well, you also need some spawn knowledge if you want to build up streaks whilst doing this. And it is actually recommended for small maps and for running and gunning. But to do this as well, you'd actually need to know how to quit scope quite well, because you really can't be missing any opportunities. So if you need to know how to quit scope and you haven't seen my quit scope tutorial before, you can go and see it, as it will be on the screen in the link. But in my later episodes on this, I'll be bringing individual map layouts, and that will go into more detail. The final thing I'll be touching on this pilot series of my run and gun sniping tactics video will be streaking, just basics on how to build up streaks and not get killed in the process.
Enemy spy plane above. Spy plane standing by. Friendly spy plane inbound.
One useful tactic I found when you're trying to build up streaks on free for all with a sniper or with any other gun, just in general, is basically something I like to call circling. Circling, or just basically moving around the same area but not staying in the same place. It's kind of weird, it will make more sense when you see the rest of the clip as well. But what you do is, when you kill someone, you never stay at the same spot, because Treyarch likes to spawn people behind you, besides you. They spawn people all around you. When you get killed, you normally do spawn quite close to the person who killed you in free for all. So you need to move around at all costs. So once you kill someone, you move on. You don't stay in the same place, but you don't move out of the area. You could easily go somewhere else, but if you move to another location, you'll miss the opportunity of killing several people in the process. So that's what I like to call circling, or just moving around the same area but not actually leaving the area. It's a very long name, I know, but yeah. It actually works out quite well with your sniper, as you can actually just pick up people from far range. You can hard scope them, you can no scope them, you might even have to quit scope them, but I think it's actually quite a useful tactic as well, because you do avoid close combat sometimes. With this tactic, you don't really even need to use your UAV, because using your UAV will only slow you down and confuse you, and it will make you stay in the same spot for too long. And if you do stay in the same spot for too long whilst using this tactic, you will get grilled. So over here, I could have killed this last person if I was more alert, but I wasn't. But anyway, in my later episodes, I'll explain in more detail on individual map setups, and I'm going to try and work my way through all of the maps in the game. Laters! Oh, and please like the video if you support the idea.